What's up, food family? Welcome back to another episode of Show Me Cuisine. It's your boy Cleazy, always with the Food Mafia. Got the OG John the Don over here. Got my man cousin Tezzy in the front. You know how we do it. And here in Missouri today, it's actually a beautiful day. And you know what? Come with me. Because it's a nice day here today, the sun is shining. We're gonna enjoy a great meal. Come with me, food family. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. It's a great day in the neighborhood. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. A beautiful day in the neighborhood. Would you wear mine? Would you wear mine? So check it. Today, we're gonna stay on the east side of the country. And we're gonna go ahead and try out a restaurant spot. Chai Shai is the name of this spot, which deal in Pakistani Indian cuisine.
Yeah.
Roll with us. Tell us what you think.
What's good, food fam? It's cousin Tez, and we out here at Lee Summit, downtown Lee Summit. It's busy, a lot of activity about lunchtime, so we're about to go down here to Bricks Pub and Grill. I mean, downtown aesthetics, man. It's pretty dope down here. Let's check it out. So I'm gonna tell y'all about the vibe of this place. The place, you know, it lives up to its name. It's called Bricks, Brick Building. It's a bar, of course. I mean, it's chill vibes. Yeah, we were talking a little earlier. You know, you get like a little Applebee's vibe, after work kind of vibe, something like that. So, I mean, it's pretty chill.
What's going on, y'all? So we're here at Bricks Pub and Grub in Lee Summit. And the vibe is, I mean, so it's Applebee's-ish, but it's unique. You know, they got a lot of like different liquor, the metal signs that you would, you know, find on like your man cave wall. They got a lot of those lying around. They definitely specialize in alcoholic drinks. So while we don't partake in that, if it is something that that you do partake in, this might be a spot for you to check out because that's really their focus. They're definitely focusing on the pub. Maybe more than the grub, we're about to find out, but a real chill, music's vibing, you know, it's not too loud, it's not too, server so far has been chill, you know, it's just a chill little place, kind of gives you that neighborhood market, that neighborhood pub type of feel where you want to come here after work and grab something to eat and drink.
So check it, we've already heard from Tezzy, we've heard from John and Don, they're pretty much correct on how they're explaining the vibe. Just like he said, I think this is like Applebee's drink 0.0. You definitely can get your drink on. I don't drink. I do got a problem with lemonades. It's pretty good.
And teas.
It's actually very flavorful.
Crap, today is sweet tea.
I'm digging it. My man John is asking about sweet tea in my shot. We're gonna ask to see if they got sweet tea. But we about to get this order popping, see if this food tastes good, because it does definitely give you that after softball game feel. You hungry? A nice group can come sit down and eat, order some of the the basic essentials to get you through before you go back home. Holla at me.
We're about to dive into these wings. I got the sweet chili wings, and I got the bricks. Is the bricks hot? Yeah, the bricks hot. This is the sweet chili. Crunchy, really crunchy. Extremely, like really sweet. I mean, you can taste just a little bit of the spiciness. Let's do this hot. This smell about to burn my nose. Hey, y'all might need to give this a try. This mug is steaming hot. Hey. I can see the steam in that. This mug hot.
I can see the steam
it's
all
temperature
right.
High and it's like sauce hot. My eyes will start watering.
What's going on, y'all? So we're back. We're at Brick's Pub. And I wanted to share a food memory with y'all, actually. So, they choking in the background, actually. It's crazy over here.
My bad.
But one of my favorite food memories growing up was actually that middle school cafeteria card that they gave you where you could go in and get whatever you wanted for like snacks and things like that. One of my favorite things was the soft pretzel. And they have the soft pretzels here with a little bit of beer cheese and a little bit of stone ground mustard. Really reminded me of that growing up in high school. Also remember the square pieces of pizza. If we ever find those at a spot, you know I'm gonna eat them too. But let me dig into this soft pretzel for y'all right now and let y'all know. Smells good. Oh wow. That's really good. It's light, it's crispy, it's well, it's just it's clearly like superior to middle school. I got these clowns laughing in the background, so I'm having a hard time keeping track of things. But A1, definitely worthy of the memory. I'm back. This is my favorite sandwich in the world. It's called a Reuben. A lot of y'all are gonna know what it is. Just feeling it. The bread is not, one side's crispy, one side's soggy. It's not, I'm concerned about the construction of this so far. And like I said, I eat these everywhere I go. My favorite sandwich is a Reuben. Let me get into some flavor and let's check it out. I would say it's too heavily sauced. I would say the corned beef is overcooked. Sauerkraut's not really sour. I'm actually upset right now.
Dr. David Banner, physician, scientist, searching for a way to tap into the hidden strengths that all humans have. Then an accidental overdose of gamma radiation alters his body chemistry. And now when David Banner grows angry or outraged, a startling metamorphosis occurs.
I can't hold like in what I'm going through. Like I said, I eat this almost everywhere I go. Like some people do Cubanos, some people do, you know, Monte Cristos. I love a good Monte Cristo, by the way. But this is, I'm severely disappointed right now.
So check it, fam. I decided to jump into the wing category as well, but I got two different flavors. I got kicking Parmesan, and then I believe I got something called spicy brown sugar. Interesting contrast. I'm looking forward to it. This boy right here also got me a little nice little cute basket.
Keyword is little.
Of onion rings. Gonna try those out to see if they got some good flavor to it. Let me dig into this kicking Parmesan and tell you what I think. Here we go.
Let's find out. They do it here for us.
Yo.
You gonna look alright?
Yeah.
Perfect. Do we need anything else right now?
No, we're good. Thank you.
Yes, I did, girl. Excuse me. Yes, I... you see me in the middle of a conversation? Don't interrupt, bro. All
right, we'll let you enjoy. All
right. This just in. My guy literally just put plates in the front of the camera. This is going in the video, by the way. Back to the kicking palm. It actually is delicious. The Parmesan is not overwhelming, but you can definitely taste the flavor. The crunch and the crispiness behind these wings, they've fried them very well, and the chicken's not dry. Definitely good on the kicking palm. You can tell the difference in color. I'm going with that spicy brown sugar. Bow, 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 bow. You don't know nothing about that D'Angelo. It's not bad. I mean, it's not heavily seasoned with brown sugar. You can taste it a little bit. And then the spicy on top of that actually gives it a good balance. I definitely recommend it.